because he belongs to Pondicherry. So he came to know that I have established a research facility there. So he came there, and the vice chancellor and others in the medical university were stunned to see him. Now, as I told you, this is for students. What is human welfare? The human welfare requires a number of things: clothing, shelter, communication, transportation, recreation, entertainment, and several others. But the algae can't do anything in all these areas. But you have other important things for human welfare: food, feed, fertilizer, fine chemicals, fuel, drugs and pharmaceuticals, waste treatment, recycling, and pollution abatement. Algae can play a very key role in all these areas. In fact, for a long time, we have purposes. Now, as people have pointed out a little earlier also, Dr. Anand and others, was considered a nuisance value, but this association is also associated. And the prokaryotic algae and cyanobacteria are entirely microscopic. Both are found in fresh as well as marine waters. That is important. And why we want to have algae and cyanobacteria for the various human welfare activities, for various goods and services? Because if you take the distribution of these algae, using it as a general term, including cyanobacteria, their distribution is rivaled only by bacteria. From Arctic to Antarctic, you get them wherever there is moisture, there is water. And another very important thing is, unlike fungi and bacteria, these are autotrophic. So you don't need to provide an expensive carbon source to grow them. They can produce their own carbohydrates and other carbon compounds. And to cultivate them naturally, you don't need expensive fermenters, you don't need expensive media, very, very simple raceway ponds, open or closed, with simple elements like even seawater and a few minerals, you can cultivate them. And it has already been proved that in some algae, particularly some of the red algae, the carbon dioxide fixing enzyme, rubisco phosphate, carboxylase, is more active than in plants. And if you take an area, because area is becoming very, very important due to increase in population, the algae can give much more biomass in lesser area than other crops. And another very important thing these days is that we want to manipulate genetically, and the genetic makeup of these algae, the cyanobacteria is much simpler, but still eukaryotic genome is not very, very complicated. And they can easily be manipulated. There is scope for the production. This is very interesting. If you take a eukaryotic algae, a green alga, for instance, it has got the nucleus, it has got chloroplast, it has got mitochondria, all of which have their own DNA. And therefore, by manipulating each one of these three DNA, you can produce at least a minimum of three totally different proteins, and then maybe you can either extract them or make them excrete them. This is not possible in any other case to get so many proteins. So this is another interesting point in this. And most of the crops, most of the plants are seasonal, whereas these organisms can be cultivated round the year, particularly in countries like ours, where there is sunlight available all through the year, 367 days. And if you look into the generation times, it may not be as small as bacteria, but definitely they are much smaller than many of the higher plants and animals and so on. And what is important is, if it is a crop plant, the entire crop plant is not useful to us. Either the fruit or the seed, or in some cases the root, or in some cases leaf or stem, it depends. One part or the other alone is useful, the rest of the biomass cannot be used for that purpose. Whereas here, the entire biomass can be used. And it is not necessary that you should have an excellent drinking water for growing them. any water, including effluent water, waste water, or sometimes even just moisture is enough to grow them. And now, because of all this, people have started developing an interest and a liking for this group of organisms, which was not there earlier. And now if you look into literature, there is an exponential increase. So much of work is going on around the world, not only in our country. And the people now start talking about, even today you heard all the fuel, biodiesel, aviation fuel, biogas, ethanol and so on. Now, thanks to people like Dr. G.S. Venkatraman and others, the organic biofertilizer became popular even among people even 5 decades ago, half a century ago. Now, all the sources of chemicals and pharmaceuticals is now increasingly realized, and more than a dozen different compounds are in various stages of clinical trial, and one or two of them have passed clinical trials as well. And what is more important is algae for waste treatment, recycling and pollution abatement. This is a remarkable area. If you ask Dr. Sivasubramanian, who is going to talk to you later, how much he is doing and becoming so popular around the world. In fact, when Subra persisted on my coming here, I had agreed. Then I was wondering what I should talk. There's no point in trying to beat the same trumpet all the time. All the work that I have done in the past is spoken so many times in so many places. But then, I want to take an area where I have neither done work. According to one of the estimates, by 2050, it is predicted that the population of the world is going to increase at least 34% and become 9.1 billion. It may even exceed, we don't know. And nearly all this population increase is going to be in developing countries like India. And another important distressing thing is urbanization. Urbanization is very rapid, and approximately 70% of the world population is going to be urban by 2050. Now it is just 49%. And whatever it is, there is going to be no increase in land area. The same land is going to remain. As a matter of fact, very soon, the salad is going to be in all 5-star hotels, the green slimy ones. You may wonder why I am saying 5-star hotels. Because it is the elitist population which can easily be induced to change in the food habit. When the mushrooms came, generally it was not taken well by people. It was not sold so much in the market. When I visited Korea long back and stayed in one of my friend's house, he served me a salad, 60% of which were seaweeds. And of course, because of non-adoption, at that time I didn't relish it so much. Maybe with the knowledge that I have today, I would have enjoyed it. Because attitudes have changed, tastes have changed, everything changes. And the microalgae also are going to be definitely the crops of the future. See, look at this. There is a company which has been recently, there are several companies, all the companies around the world that do in US. This one is one of the recent companies, Solazyme. And this fellow, soon after starting the company, within about 10 to 12 years, has got an award in US for the 2015 Technology Innovation Award. And the CEO of that is Jonathan Olson. You have to take a cue from him, the students here. As a student, he suddenly got interested in algae. Then he decided, okay, after I finish my studies, I'm definitely going to set up an industry using these algae. And then initially he thought that these are useful only for fuel purposes. So he wanted to start an algal fuel factory. But then when he started the factory along with some others, he found as time went by, he found that they are useful not only for fuel production, there are plenty of other uses. He was really astonished to see the promises of algae. Now, he understood that algae is a foundation for all plant life on this planet. When they first talked about the company, they didn't really understand algae. Because the fellow had just come out of college. And he started it in 2003, in 2005, then he started understanding. And then they said, they are not only good for fuel, but they are excellent sources of food as well. And microalgae production has really started in this country for various other purposes, including granular cultivation for beta carotene and so on, spirulina cultivation, all these have started. But you don't have too many market products. Many products are not there still. And according to Milton Summerfield, specialty market, specialty, specialty food market has an excellent space for all the foods. And I want to, in this connection, recollect my great friends, Dr. L. V. Venkatraman. He was not only my friend, he was my teacher as well, with whom I am associated till date. And Dr. C. V. Seshadri, the late Dr. C. V. Seshadri, who suddenly disappeared from us in the Madras beach. And Dr. G. G. Boy, who could not be here, otherwise she would have definitely been here. She is away in US. These people have contributed a lot to spirulina, not as food, but as a food supplement. But they made an attempt. I don't remember the exact year, maybe in the 80s or 90s, they conducted a special workshop-like thing or seminar in Mahabalipuram in Chennai, near Chennai. And then they started specially preparing several of our South Indian dishes. Spirulina, as I told you, was not taken as a food item, but it was taken as a health supplement, a food supplement. So spirulina tablets even today are available in our market. And the Solazine was the first fellow to have developed algal protein powders. And these protein powders can be used in place of algal powders, eggs, butter and vegetable oils in foods, as well as the protein supplements such as the protein milkshake and so on, chocolate shake and all that. Now, the future of food industry is definitely going to be algae dependent. They have produced, the same company, Solazyme, has produced another product, algal flour. The advantage of the algal flour is it is very low in saturated fats. There is no trans fat at all. Trans fat is considered to be something very bad for our health. It is not there at all. There is no cholesterol at all. And he says, Watson says, if you are looking at standard nutritional label, I have to show you what it is. For 20 times more productive, with little needed in the way of input to keep them alive. As I told you, the Rubisco is better and all that. Now, this is the branded item that Solazyme has produced. There is alga avaya, and it's a lipid-rich powder, incredible mouthfeel. It enables the formulation of healthier products. A multi-component whole food ingredient. The term whole food nowadays is becoming very important. When you want to go and buy a bread, you ask for a whole wheat bread. People who are health conscious are interested in whole grain or whole. Why? Because when you process it and separate it, they say it is not good for health. That is why the whole powder, whole grain powder is important. If you take your maida, atta and all that, they are not whole grain. They are processed. They are not good for health. People with diabetes should not take them. So, he says, so whole food, this is a multi-component whole food ingredient with rich in healthy lipids, dietary fiber, protein and micronutrients. Multifunctional, to show you how this algal flour would look. You would have expected it to all look green. Of course, it can be made to look green if it is just powdered as it is. But chlorophyll can be very easily removed, and then you will get some beautiful colored algal flour like this, which will be very tasty. Now, this flour, it has made a breakthrough. Microalgae-based platform leverages fermentation technology to produce highly nutritious, naturally derived, minimally processed ingredients. That's why whole, for outstanding consistency. Whole Alvar flour adds unique taste, texture, and nutritional benefits when included in the formulation of many different food products, including sweet baked, because of its health benefits. In supermarkets in our own country, though olive oil is not made in our country, it is imported. So much is selling here. So this concept of saying it is expensive, people won't buy it, all that doesn't hold water anymore. And what are the advantages? It's a whole food ingredient, as I told, other animal products also. They only claim we are not killing the animal. But it's not as if we can produce only algal flour. Already people know about algal oil. They are looking at it only as